I felt thin as death. I've been living on an endless supply of week-old donuts. They were fuel for this crazy furnace inside my head. I couldn't remember when I had last seen the sun. I was on a permanent graveyard shift. When the darkness fell, New York City became something else, any old Sinatra song notwithstanding. Bad things happened in the night, on the streets of that other city, Noir York City. I was in an all-night diner, downing cup after cup of coffee that tasted like engine oil, when a new message from BB got me back on the killer track.
What the hell happened at Roscoe Street? Maxie, I'm going out on a limb here. We need to talk this through, come up with a plan. 2:30 a.m., the Choir Communications Garage.
The more I thought about Alex's murder and the frame-up, the more it felt like an inside job. I should have seen it coming. BB had sold me out, and now he wanted to finish what he'd started. The garage was dead. BB showed up in his tailor-made suit, gold watch, and cufflinks to match, all way beyond a cop's pay.
Maxie.
Oozing suave charm, he was guilty as hell. What the hell does BB stand for anyway? Backstabbing bastard?
Come on, don't be like that. Have a cigar.
I don't smoke.
Maxie, you have no idea how big this is. It's huge. You have no idea.
I think I do. You're a bribe-taking bent cop who sold out his partner. Those mobsters in the subway were a dead giveaway. Hard to miss. Bet it was exactly like this with Alex. Up close and personal.
You can't win this one, Max.
No, but I can make damn sure none of you do either. BB turned out to be another cardboard cutout bad guy. Bad cop on the take, a cowardly right-hand man fleeing from the scene, leaving his paid thugs to do his dirty work.
Okay, now we're just gonna... There could be a secret up here. Like, why is that off color? Oh. This is elaborate. Oh shit. Who is this?
Hello to everyone at Remedy. This is Jamie and Renault.
Hello.
Hey, how you doing? And this is hopefully the last session we've done for you, or we're going to do for you. It's been a pleasure working on this game. We hope you like the audio. Good luck with bringing it home. And we're with you on it all the way. And again, thank you very much. And the game rocks.
Thank you very much. And it was a pleasure meeting you guys at E3. And we hope that this is everything you need. And we're there for you, and we can't wait to see it come out.
Yeah, thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Not a friend, ladies, are you, Trebek? We'll take famous titties for 200.
Okay, take it easy!
So the Rockstar employee is giving some of the lines for the game. Thank you. No, I'm just gonna like, you're stupid. So trash it. This part. Okay, let's go, boys. There's no way he could have killed me while he was jittery as fuck. See? The jittery as fuckness cannot be killed. Yes, of course. Go. There was like, what, 17 guys in that area? No, 17 guys. I like it how that guy just I just took a shot to the face. I'm fine.
Ah!
Was he just... Okay, every time he got hit, it's just like... Why won't you die? I'm out of ammo.
Reports of a fire at the Punchinello Manor in Westchester. The manor is the home of Angelo Punchinello, the alleged head of the Punchinello crime family. The police are now saying, contrary to their earlier statements, that Max Payne is still alive and at large. He continues his vendetta against the Mafia, of which this last act of arson is attributed to.
I had no recollection of setting any fires, but I did remember the flames.
Okay. I'm fearing for my fucking life. So I'm not taking any fucking chances. Nobody on the left. This is fucking SWAT 4 all over again. Or Manhunt. Oh shit. Oh shit, here we go again. Well, I think I killed him. Oh, look, a Zach hammer. If I stand on the car, will I take damage? Oh, hell no. No. Professional gamer.
Payphone started to ring.
Which payphone?
Yeah.
Max Payne.
Whatever does it for you.
Building presently. We are expecting you.